She let the audience down
gently
with the right amount of time. 4,000 players registered. Got it out there. Here are the final
five. Smaller tweets into me. Apparently, the Red Pants finally made it onto the stream. He's been hearing about them all day, and he's glad he got to see them.
Oh, Anna Kate, genius, says PLO 6-max, answering Jason Rifkin's question about games.
What to see at the Borgata?
It would be very difficult logistically, probably.
Why?
Just because I think 6-max is just tough for them in general.
I mean, they run 6-max no limit, though.
Yeah, and I
think PLO will be smaller, theoretically.
Put it like this. I think that if 6-max were logistically like the same, they would run more of them because it's so popular.
It's not as popular as 10-handed, though.
No, it's just not. For sure. No, you're right. I just think if they could, they would run more 6-max. Not if they could, but I just think it's a very... There's less dealers per that for them to work with.
And she caught him. Then just gets very unfortunate. All right.
She runs Jessica will win seven.
We had it.
Jessica sure gets through.
Nikolai is probably pretty frustrated. It's basically his only move he's made all day. Is a Flavers Wine Race with 7-2, and he actually shows it, which is kind of funny.
Poker Beast says, I don't see how Dolly doesn't win this tournament. The players at this table suck.
Well, that's nice.
Somehow, Poker Beast was available as a name on YouTube.
Poker Beast is really going off.
Shog was 7-8.
I read you. So red for the 7-8.
Guys, one thing everyone in these chats should remember, this is a $560 buy-in tournament with 4,000 people in it. All sorts of players and types will make the final table.
That's why we play
the
poker.
The awesome part about it. Yeah.
You could be here.
You could be this person.
I mean, not you, because you're genuinely terrible, but other people.
The official, the real legend himself is all in.
The theoretical you.
Everything else stops.
Correct.
Now.
The royal you.
Here he comes. We're focusing on Joseph. Joseph, for those that are just joining us, started the final table with one big blind. What did he win? The first four pots of the final table?
He won
table?
The first four hands. He quadrupled up, then he doubled up, and then he won two hands in a row.
Well. He will win this one as well.
Back at it. Getting those big ones.
He is all business.
Have you noticed a change in the player's demeanor? Feels like people are a lot more relaxed now than they were when the final table first started. See Jessica chatting it up. Nikolai's even opened up a bit, smiling a bit.
That's what happens when you're guaranteed $90,000.
I was going to say, it doesn't hurt that they're the only two chips also.
100%. That is what happens when you're guaranteed this much money. Which is crazy because they're all guaranteed 90, and it's like 90.
90's a lot.
$90,000 is so much money. But they're playing for 325. They're playing to 3.5 times what they're guaranteed right now,
absolutely.
Which is the difference between buying yourself a car and buying yourself and your mother and your father and putting your and paying your mortgage. Like it's a big difference. $325,000 can at least go a little way towards changing someone's life. $90,000
would
just make it better.
I would assume it would change most people's lives.
The people at this table probably most of their lives, yeah.
I think.
Fortunately,
any of us back here, I think it would do okay for you.
It would do a lot for me. I mean, Uncle Sam is a bastard, which is really unfortunate. And a walk for my boy.
Shows the ace.
Should have shown the deuce.
Show the other one, you goober.
Goober.
Come on. You got to show the ace.
He's bringing goober
That's
back.
That's like the rule.
You show the deuce, and the guy gets pissed he gave you a walk.
Don't you want more walks?
Yeah. All right.
A walk gave him 10% more to his.
Who invited this kid? He always is right. It's annoying.
Gagliano.
Yeah, Gags. He's always right. Yeah.
It's what I live for, you know, just being right all the time. So. No, I mean, you know. Come on, Ash. Everyone loves a walk.
Everyone loves a walk pot. All
right, cards
are. I really hope we see Nikolai start opening up and not let that 7 deuce kind of discourage him a bit because he does have the chips to do it. Just start throwing some raises out there, see what happens. I think if we see Jessica get chips, she's the one that's going to do that. You know that?
She plays pretty fearlessly from what I've seen of her.
Yeah.
On Poker Night in America, she's not a big backer downer.
We haven't seen too much from Federico this final table yet.
No, we haven't. He's been lying in the weeds, which I think is not a bad strategy.
Absolutely.
I mean, look, he's already guaranteed fifth or better.
Especially with the way stacks are. There's just not a whole bunch he can do.
Wow, so Jessica doesn't even have a lot of chips.
No, she's gotten pretty short.
So right there, that Cirrus on your screen starts the same with 26 big blinds.
I would imagine you'll see him call here.
We'll make the call and we'll see a flop.
He did call. And he is going to see a flop literally. He put his glasses on.
Our flop is Queen of Hearts, Queen of Spades, Six of Clubs.
Probably my favorite part of watching poker is things like this. When everyone has nothing to see how it plays out.
Sure.
Who does what?
Everyone still has nothing.
And everyone's going to check it down.
Yeah, I have a feeling $0.
I don't know. I think we might see Sirius get in there. I got faith.
Check, check on the flop. Now the eight of diamonds comes out. Sirius checks again. And
Federico's betting. This is probably going to be his pot to win.
It is 1 billion to go.
I mean, Sirius hasn't shown any action, any interest in the pot. You don't think he's just trying to take it down?
I just think he's going to call with all the better hands than ace five and fold with all the worse hands.
That feels, I tend to
except for 7-9 and 5-7, which are still like
have good equity.
Have good equity. Well, I mean, he may just check fold 5-7 and 7-9.
I mean, a lot of people don't necessarily think like that.
Is this just preventing you from getting bluffed later?
People, I think people think that way.
Is there,
is there merit in that?
There's just so few
sort of
cards. Yeah.
You know, I don't expect Sirius to necessarily be like aggressively trying to take this pot away from me on all rivers. You know, against some players, maybe I could see that. But against Sirius, I'd be pretty happy to just check. Even though I said I thought he might bluff.
Paul Santara on YouTube says ace
just
high has to
call
bet.
Anything.
I mean, if he was going to bet, I would generally just bet the flop.
Poker Beast agrees with you. This is all caps, so you know it's serious. So not it a fan of this bet.
Has to be true. Caps on the internet are serious business.
Aaron Riley says, give my hat to Joe. There's luckily, or unfortunately rather, there's more than one Joe out there.
I think
so
he means the Joe in question.
Oh.
The Joe?
I could walk out and give him the hat, and then 30
I'll tell you.
Will be
speaking of Joe's, we had a dude 904 reference, Joe McKeon. If our Joe, our one big blind Joe, wins this tournament, he will be the Joe.
He
so,
will.
So Joe McKeon will have some work to do come November, and he'll have to take back the title of the
if
Joe.
I'm
going
to have to go down from chip leader to one chip to back
I think so, yeah.
Joe.
If I could possibly have already been rooting for Joe enough, that pretty much locks it in, just that he'll take all Joe McKeon's shine. It's pretty awesome. Like Joe McKeon a lot, but, you know, I'm just tired of him.
The Camposato.
Go lose a tournament or something.
I just want to point out this little Twitter conversation that I'm referring to here.
This is a pretty big flop. By the way, we'll catch up with this in a second.
James Hunt tweets at Will OC the blogger. He says, "Your hair day looks just great on the stream, buddy. Keep it up." And Will responds with, "Thank you, fans. Please include hashtag Borgata Poker Live for all future compliments."
Will is a. You don't want to compliment that guy. He is just annoying.
All right, hold on. So we had some action here.
Yep.
Limp pop pre-flop.
Sirius is pop top pair. He comes out with a bet. And Nikolai puts some aggression on. What do you think about this raise?
That is 1.1 million.
I don't
like
it very
much.
I don't hate it.
You would just call.
I would call. I think more than anything else, he's just putting. Well, I love the raise.
Love
now.
The
I think
raise is amazing.
It's
what I meant
raise.
To say.
Yeah.
It's such a good raise. Like I would probably never not make that raise. The more that I think about it, it probably is a contender for raise of the year.
They probably shouldn't have people in
the
booth
if the board
who
wasn't,
don't know
if
what
the board
they're talking
wasn't
about when they say it's a bad raise. Like I'm not really sure why I'm here. But and then the other thing is like, so if he has a 10, this is actually like an awful. It's
yeah,
like
it's
a good
a
card,
card,
but it's a bad card.
He's gonna fold a lot if
fold
he has a 10
all the time.
Now you're hoping he's the 8.
And I just think the bigger part is, like, when Nikolai doesn't get there on the turn of the river, like, yeah, on one hand, it's good to have the onus of betting and to, like, be aggressive. But, like, if he has a 10 or 8, he's not going to fold later streets unless the board gets crazier. So you just have the onus on you to bet in a spot where you're not going to get a lot of your opponent's rage to fold. Like, once he bets the flop and then calls Nikolai's raise serious, he has a good hand. And so now you're trying to get a strong hand to fold, which is just, like, generally rough.
Plus, is the problem, what if he has an 8? What if he comes back over the top?
Right. Yeah, no, a lot of time you're not going to get to realize your equity in those spots. Yeah, I think a call is good. But obviously, when you know a jack's coming, it's genius. I'll tell you that much.
Tough decision here for Sirius, though. You can still put him on clubs. You can still put him on...
Good fold.
I think it's a good fold too, but
and serious fold.
I mean, if even if you think he's bluff raising the flop, that card is just like the jack just hits everything.
Yeah, exactly.
I need to see what he has.
Anything that you were beating before is now beating him. Yeah.
I'm pretty impressed with Sirius so far. I just think he's been pretty solid, not making any huge mistakes, just hanging out.
Sirius is on fire.
Oh man. It was a reach, but it worked.
It's okay. We got to reach sometimes. So I wanted to get to there was a guy on Twitch who thinks that the three of us should commentate the Aussie Millions. What do you guys say? You want to go do it?
Boy.
That's a long plane ride.
Yeah.
Nick Camposato. Why can't you guys come and commentate Aussie Millions?
Wait, hold on. We got to go back up. I don't think Stapes is allowed in Australia after the 2011 incident. Please expound.
I can't because I've never been to Australia.
Is that true?
Yeah. There's no story there.
I also wish everyone could see your computer right now because you're running through four timelines simultaneously. This is impressive.
I got my Twitter timeline. I got my at replies. I got my Borgata Poker Live hashtag. I got my Borgata Poker Open hashtag.
I don't know how to do anything you have going on up there. I just open.
This is a computer.
So
I open Safari and go from there. Like, I don't even know what you have. Some
that's a special
up.
Twitter program.
Yeah.
So what's really great is when it shows what my like most commonly viewed sites are. And
I don't think we can show any of those
always,
on air. Is that
there's always one of these that pops up.
Oh, it's an online shopping site, guys, if you were wondering.
He's really into his shoes.
Shopping of sorts. Looking at things I can't afford, if that's what you mean.
Well, it's not really shopping because you never actually spend any money.
It's window shopping. And I usually have several windows open at once.
Oh boy.
So there's a reason they have that mature audiences warning on the Twitch chat, right?
It's my first time working for you people. I gotta keep it tame.
I think this is interesting. I believe it went limp and then check and then pre-flop and then check on the flop. Nikolai leads. If he bets twice, it's like really, really hard for Jessica to call. Two times.
Is she just gonna fold here even?
I don't think it's the worst thing, but I would not. Not even because I can see their hands. I mean, you just, like, have to protect your hands. At times. Oh.
Whoa.
Yeah. That's going to work.
She's going to bluff out the worst hand. It's going to feel like a big victory for her there.
I think I like Jessica a lot. I think that's a massive mistake on her part, to be frank.
Do you think that you get you think, obviously, no ace's fault.
No,
no queen's fold.
You think no queen's
fold?
Either.
I don't think so. What is she checking back the flop with that she's ripping the turn?
I mean, she could have like
a set of eights,
pairs, ten queen eight,
what,
ten
what,
eight.
What hand did she check back the flop with?
Yeah, queen eight, ten eight.
I guess queen eight, ten eight. Yeah,
jack nine,
eight.
Probably
nine.
She probably raised pre
with
eights.
Just rips
no?
the turn with the nuts.
I mean,
that seems pretty.
She probably bet the flop too, but I mean, it's not out of the question.
I just see your question, Mike. That means I would have had to been watching the flop action.
Pre-flop.
Excuse me, pre-flop the pre-flop action. What comes before flop?
Before the flop?
Yeah.
It's before the flop, so they call it the pre-flop.
Pre-flop.
Like before the flop comes out.
Pre and before are kind of one
and
the same.
Oh, my goodness. That's what pre-flop
wait,
is.
Joe,
I honestly just learned that right
after
now.
After the flop comes out?
Yes.
They call that the, like, post-flop action.
Post-flop.
Because it's after
it's
the flop
It's because they put
out.
The flop down on that little thing that looks like a post.
Yeah,
a
yeah.
Spot on the felt is a
you can tell yourself that,
this is poker edumacation right here, for sure.
Now settle this one for me. Is it whole cards or is it hold cards?
It's whole cards.
It's not because of the cards they're holding. It's not the hold cards.
No, it's not the hold cards, and it's not
hold
W H O L E. It's not that.
No,
either.
Because we're seeing the whole card, the W H O L E. We're seeing the
Stapes
whole thing.
Stapes is onto something here.
But
I think.
But they're called like cards that are in the hole.
Can we just compromise and call them the whole cards?
The whole cards.
Like we're doing coverage with whole
the
whole cards.
The whole hold cards.
Here's the question.
Yeah, the whole cards.
Do we think that Jessica Dolly's teeth are naturally this white? Or do
well,
we
no one's teeth are.
I mean, she has some white teeth going on right now.
Use the hashtag white teeth. No.
I mean, those are pretty white teeth.
Look, Dane has a problem with the way we're pronouncing Sirius. His name.
How do we pronounce it?
We're saying Sirius. When we're adding an extra I in there, mostly because we're sponsored by satellite radio, and he's upset that we should be saying Sirius.
I was told before the broadcast that it was pronounced Sirius.
Well, I just think of it like
now,
Sirius Black.
There are a lot of people.
Potter.
But is it? Is
there
it
a lot of know-it-alls on the internet who will say something like
no
this,
way.
Even though they don't really
they don't
know.
Actually
is
know,
that
right?
Yeah. Is that true? I'd be surprised, because I thought everything you read on the internet has to be true. It's that that's a law somewhere, I thought.
Okay, Tab and Dane also this, says, in case you couldn't hear the audio, Tab Ducho, which clearly isn't Ducho, last name is pronounced Duchateau.
Duchateau. The thing is, when people write these phonetic pronunciations, we don't realize
is
Dane
Doe or Do?
Is that D-O has many ways that you could pronounce it also. So, there's a thing that I say, I do a lot on my broadcasts, Mike and Asher, and you guys probably haven't heard it yet, which is this. The number one rule for being a know-it-all is be right.
Know-it-all.
That's a good rule.
Actually be right. Yeah. So when you write a very ambiguous do chateau or do chateau,
I think
still,
he's going for do.
You're not really right. Right. Well, that's how we'd say if it's a word. But if you're going to pronounce like do, re, mi, fa, so
that's true.
Spelled
that's
D-O.
True. That is spelled D-O.
One of the more interesting people I've met through poker, Kenny Baden, says, Cirrus sat to my right last time I played at Borgata, and he told me to be patient. That's how he plays. Nice man.
And Dane has written to say it's actually not Linda Kenny Baden, it's Linda Kenny Baden.
Ah, Linda Kenny Baden. It's like, not like tomato, tomato, Baden.
I don't. I was just getting thrown a Dane joke.
She's
in
awesome,
there.
Though. She's also quite accomplished. Jessica.
Look at that fur.
Oh, no, she rocks all the finest furs.
She's wearing two animals. She's got a fur coat and a dog purse.
She was played in a movie by, I want to say Helen Mirren.
Really?
Yes, she was part of Phil Spector's murder trial.
Is it a movie about a sexy ass lawyer?
Yeah, it says it right in her Twitter.
Linda, get
Mirren.
In touch.
Joseph, this is interesting because he only has 10 blinds and he's open to 3 blinds with ace 7. So I assume he's going with it.
I would not know. I don't think he may even know.
Yeah, no, he only had 2 million back. I would be absolutely floored if he didn't.
So some people in the Twitch chat are giving Jessica a bit of a hard time for her celebrating. What do you think? Is she being over the top celebrating?
Oh, my goodness.
Is it,
that was
is
so
it, is it
fine, man. People, it's so easy to hate a pretty girl, man. People give girls such a hard time.
I think it's
time.
More than that, though. I think she's also kind of, it's like hard to understand the rapport at the table without knowing it. But, like, she's talking all the time. She's constantly, you can see.
It was like a fake celebration. It wasn't
yeah,
like
she's
a real
joking with the other person. She's half celebrating. I wouldn't think twice about
it's
it.
It's not like
ever.
She was like, yeah, in your face. Suck it.
And Stapes just yelled loud enough for the people in Borgata, in the Taj across the boardwalk. Everyone heard him. Play has actually stopped while they figure out who did that yelling.
Their security is on its way.
They're worried a woman is being mauled somewhere. Cirrus, sorry, is not backing down. Although he will have to eventually back down. In this hand. A lot of people playing blind versus blind with really poor hands.
We have. That seems to be the theme of this final table.
People are not trying to fold their small blind. Wow.
And he's been caught.
Nikolai says, eat this. 34.6 million. Obviously, effectively, that is more like 7 or 8 million, but. And now Cirrus is taking precious seconds of our lives that we'll never have back.
He's trying to save a little face. He's trying to keep that patient game kind of, you know.
His cards don't even add up to a jack.
I don't understand why people look back at their cards here. Like,
I don't understand why people
go in the tank here. Because you're trying to sell the fact that you have a decision. That's all.
Here's my point, right? So if Cirrus had, what's like a pretty good hand that can't call here? What's like the best hand he can't call?
Like, I don't know.
King 9, right? There's nothing wrong with him raising. And there's nothing wrong with him folding. So he could clearly rep having a decent hand that he had to fold.
Right.
And he could save 45 seconds of everyone's life.
But is he even King 9, is he realistically ever going to call with that hand?
No.
No.
That's what I'm
but
saying.
But why do you have to save? So you just fold. Like,
you just fold right away. That's
yeah,
exactly
I would,
my
that's
point.
What
yeah,
I just, someone goes, they're like, all in. I'm like, yeah, you're in.
Yeah.
My hand but maybe he wants to sell the fact that he can make a huge laydown and fold
that's
King
true.
Queen.
Maybe.
Also, people know that people bluff. Like, the rumor, like, the secret's out. Everyone knows that bluffing exists. So it's like, you can just fold right away.
Right, you're not
you're bluffing.
Like,
yeah,
yeah
like,
yes, I was bluffing. It happens.
It happens. Everyone,
sue me.
The tightest player bluffs. Like,
doesn't
no
mean you're bluffing the next time.
Right. And if anything, you're probably not. So it's better off having them think you bluffed the next time. Or last time, rather.
You're my big one. Oh.
Did Federico always have these shades out? Only during hands?
He's been putting them on and off. I think they were, they've been on for most part. That's what I said. We have not seen too much from him.
No, he's been very quiet. So he's folding here. He's playing very tight. Not that it's a bad fold, because it's not. Wow. Ace three out the door, ace four. They are geniuses.
How do they know?
Steeps. He is not going to fold to a three bet this time. No Hollywood.
No,
necessary.
I don't think so.
1.5.
This is a
raise
dangerous 1.
spot.
1.5
million. Nikolai folds.
Fortunately for her, it's not looking like it'll be the case here.
Unfortunately for her, he's raised huge, so she can't call. Which
no.
Would be nice. It's a decent hand. She's very personable. She's
oh, I can't even believe how she smiled as she folded there. It's horrible. It's just the worst etiquette.
He told, he actually.
Oh, look at her needling him, too. Oh, geez. Oh, you raised too much.
Yeah,
I would never play poker with you.
Disgracing the game of poker
just
as we
totally
speak.
Totally.
Look at him, too. I mean, come on.
What
dude.
Is he thinking? Laughing? Having? What are these people thinking? Having fun playing?
He wins
poker.
The hand and then he laughs at her. Look
everyone,
at him, look.
Everyone is clearly having such a good time at this small table, which
awesome.
I really like.
It's awesome.
Even Nikolai, who's like we said, you know, showing like he's a little nervous at times. He's just loving life right now.
And for a nervous guy, he's been playing pretty decent. I think Joseph will be moving all in. Maybe he will be folding. His hands seem like they don't know what to do.
I just want every player at this table to know that they're all winners in my book. Especially Joseph Silva. No matter what happens, buddy, you were supposed to go out first, and you didn't. You were the little engine that could. You're Stone Fox dying right before the finish line.
You got to wonder if that A6 would have gotten through here.
Nope.
And he's, look at Joe's the best.
He does. Joe's got something.
Dude.
He's got a sixth sense we don't know about.
He's got Wolverine-like instincts. He could just smell these ladies.
Jessica gets very serious all of a sudden. Is she?
Yes, she did.
Has his hand here.
And Rico? Oh, Rico. This is a bad situation for you.
Mm.
I don't know when I decided to start calling him Rico, but we're there now.
No, he's a Rico.
When he puts the glasses on,
he's Rico with the glasses for sure.
Pop is, and spades, eight of spades.
A bad flop for Jessica.
Yeah, not the one you're really looking for, but I mean, she's got the queen of spades. It's not that bad.
Well, yeah, but like her hand is great on this flop, and it's nice that she has spades, but also her opponent has just
I think
the
queen of spades like is you looks good to you at first, and then you realize when the last spade hits, you're either losing or your action's killed.
Right.
So
maybe, but it can get
it's
you out of
about
some
when all the money gets in also.
Yeah, she's not that
river.
Deep. She can have some situations where he may have two pairs or, you know, even some straights here where you actually have still good equity. So
yeah, for sure.
You definitely prefer to have it than not have it in the spot.
Falls, Jessica wins the pot.
And by the way,
see that smile she gave after she won?
Oh, she looks back at her cards, the needle. Look at she's raking those chips and just rubbing it in
grosses
everyone's face.
Me out.
Oh my gosh, she just told Rico, she said, I think you're the worst poker player I've ever seen.
I saw that,
yeah.
Did you hear that?
Did you see that? By the way, Real Mad Bomber in touch on Twitch say Linda Kenny Bodden defended Phil Spector in his first murder trial. She was played by Helen Mirren in the movie. Al Pacino played Phil Spector.
Also, Poker is Life Durr has a great point. She has queens again. She's like Darvin Moon.
Lol.
As she's had, I think, two big hands this entire final table.
I think Poker is Life Durr is bugging everyone in the chat.
Yeah. Mookie hit him with the you're Darvin Moon.
You're Darvin Moon. Your face is Darvin Moon.
It's a good point about her balance. Mookie 88 says she smiled and raised her hands to her rail, both with King Deuce off and pocket queens.
It's important.
So she's got some celebration balance range. Oh, baby. Rico.
Oh, here comes Rico.
Here he comes.
Here are the big stacks, the two big
the
stacks.
The clankers.
Never heard that before. The clankers.
Rico re-raises.
3.25.
$3,250.
I'm about ready for a good old-fashioned cooler sometime soon, you know?
This is the big biggest sort of lull in bust-outs or action in general that we've seen in the whole final table so
how
far.
How big's the prize jump between
well, let's see here.
That could account for some of it.
Fifth place is 92,000, and fourth is 116,000. So it's the same as it was from fifth to sixth.
20K.
Yeah, about 20,000. And then they're going to jump another about
23 to third place, and that's when the real big jumps start. So, you know, I mean, obviously $20,000 is a ton of money for anybody, but it's not as big as, you know, some of the jumps that we see at different times at these final tables.
Yeah.
Poker's Life has apologized to me on Twitch. It's not me. It's the rest of the chat. There's other people out there. We really haven't seen a lot of post-flop pots just in general. You know, no one's opening up. I mean, even you just see Nikolai folding 9-7 suited there.
But who's stacked for it? Who's rolled to play post-flop poker? Right, you need someone to play with, though,
I guess. But, I mean, you'll run into some hands that just happen to call or people call out of the big blind. And
1.25 million. I think he has more than 3.5 million, maybe.
Now, there's no reason for the tank here unless you're actually considering something. Cirrus.
I mean, maybe I'm a fish, but I would call if I were Cirrus. Or Cirrus.
Looks like he's considering it, at least.
I just mean, I think, like, Joseph's just going to shove every flop, and you either hit and
you either hit or you
or
don't,
Yeah, you miss and fold. It's very simple.
Yeah, he's not going anywhere, it looks like.
Cirrus makes a call. Going to the flop, heads up.
And Joseph will be, that's what we call gin when you have king five against nine.
Kind of an interesting flop.
Yeah. He has one pot size bet. Yeah, he has to call.
I mean, can Cirrus fold here?
Has to call.
He does, right?
He cannot call pre-flop and then fold.
I don't think so either, especially when, you know, he kind of called out Joe's plan here before the flop. Instead of
shoving every time.
Well, shoving every time, yeah.
I do wonder if it was jack 7-4 if you would shove. I don't know.
I would think Joe so.
Yeah,
remember he shoved the queen jack earlier on the 10 high? Just
That was bananas. That other hand against Will.
$2,400,000.
That was absolute bananas.
Wild Deuces says, seriously fold the ace then raise the king 5 suited?
Oh, they were in very different positions. The ace was under the gun.
Well, got called. And when you get called, you think you're in big trouble, but no, it's Domination Nation.
We need to have Joe needs to buy a new sweatshirt or something.
Really upsetting if you're serious here. Like, you're like, he's got nothing. I'm going to call. I call, and he's, like, not happy. And then you see his hand, you're like, oh, well, he sort of had nothing.
And you also don't expect, like, you expect your five to be live.
Yeah,
like, you
it's
know,
a roller coaster of emotions, this spot.
Oh, and that's a good card for Sirius. He's going to add some outs.
I forgot I'm rooting for Joe, though. So.
Picks up eights. It's just obligatory. You have to root for a sweat on the turn. You can still want your guy to win.
There it is.
That is the brick we were looking for.
He looks like he looked almost upset about that river card.
It's hard to know whether you won or not sometimes.
He kind of looks like a celebrity who, like, grows all his hair and facial hair out so no one will recognize him. You know, and then, like, wears a big hoodie and walks around. No one knows who it is.
Hoodie with some, what we're going to assume is paint on it.
We had a gentleman on day one who got he had king 10 all in versus, I don't know, some better hand, like ace king or something like that. And it came out 10 high, and he was all excited, and the turn was an ace, and he was behind. But he turned the flush draw, and he didn't realize it, and the river was a heart. And he got up, he thought he lost, and the other guy in the hand was, you know, went to shake his hand, he thought he won. And the dealer started pushing to the pot, the guy with the ace king, and some other guy at the table was like, yeah, he's got a flush. And I was like, yeah, that guy wins.
Did the dealer know?
No, the dealer had no idea. The dealer thought that the other guy had was one of those things. You see the guy leaving and, you know.
Sure.
I mean, not anything. The dealers have been great here all series, but it's just one of those spots where no one realized that he didn't win.
Dealers make mistakes just like all other humans. People sometimes forget that, apparently.
Yeah, people give dealers such a hard time, and they have tough jobs.
I hate it. I hate the way people treat dealers. It's really crazy.
I can't remember. I heard a story recently about someone who basically got busted out of a tournament because of a missed deal and was like, people make mistakes.
It happens.
God, I heard, like, the exact same story recently, and I can't remember what it is.
Something happened at a tournament I was covering recently where there was been a missed deal, but there was significant action had happened, and they let the hand play out, and that's why that story came up.
Was this in Barca?
Yeah.
I think I read this hand or this story.
Okay. Yeah, it was at the final table.
I really wish I had any sort of memory of specifically what I read, but I don't.
You guys can find it if you want.
Yeah, I'm sure.
But I think Joseph has become, Joe's become very difficult to play against in the sense that, so he had 15 big blinds, and he opens under the gun for four, or I'm sorry, he opened on the button right there for four big blinds.
It's the big one, everybody. It's a 4.6.
But
everybody get
calling.
To a doorway.
Oh, man. I think it's such, like, you never see that in poker. Someone with 15 big blinds make it four big blinds.
I mean,
when
you
they're folded.
See it. It's not as common.
Usually you just assume they're going to call off.
Yeah,
those
you don't see it. I mean, that's something that.
Don't you guys feel like short stack play has evolved a lot lately?
It's evolved a ton. I mean,
that used to be like anything like 18 big blinds and lower, it was like all interfold every single hand.
Well,
and
we
now
can,
you can like call out of the big blind with like eight big blinds.
We can even go further back than that when. You know, people were first figuring out short stack play, and no one really, you just kind of would wait until you would do things, and then when you get to like 10 or 12 big blinds, you would just kind of go all in and hope for the best.
With any two, basically.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then people figure out, hey, guess what? I should be shoving certain hands, and I should be folding certain hands, and then they evolve that strategy, you know, of open shoving, and you used to see 15, 20 big blind open shoves all the time. And you definitely don't see that as much.
It still happens, and it still should
happen
at times, but definitely more few and far between.
I actually love that evolution, though, because I do feel like the sort of, like, blinding away to nothing is kind of like a quote-unquote fishy play, and that's actually becoming more and more acceptable because it just makes sense. Like, it's one of those few things that, like, logically, when you're playing, you're like, well, if I get called with this hand, I'm probably not ever going to win, so why would I shove with it? Like, I'd rather just hang on. And that, I like that at least in one instance where, like, a very sort of rudimentary understanding of the game is probably correct.
Yeah.
Jessica has clearly decided to attack Federico every single time it folds to her small blind.
She seems to just be attacking more in general.
Yeah, for sure.
And this is why I said if she gets chips, I think she's going to have a really good shot at running away with this.
Yeah, she's definitely an attacker. I mean, her hand just sucks. That's the only problem.
I'll tell you, she's going to win the pot, though.
Yeah, she probably is going to win the hand.
This will show you aggression pays if she continues with it. It's not a great flop, but she's going to.
This is your plan, though. I mean, you don't expect to hit gin.
Very interesting. She bets about half what she bet when she had queens.
Oh, she's going to get floated?
I think she's going to get more than floated.
Give me a raise.
When she had queens, she bet $1.8 million on the flop with the same preflop sizing. And here she bets $850,000.
This raise is so fishy, though. Like, what is he ever actually raising here? Like, king 7 and king 6 specifically?
6x of spades, king 7,
king 6. You could have 7-6. You could have some big draws.
I just think people are going to slow play this.
Also, she blocks his straight draws, which sucks. Jessica
lays it. It's not out of the question that he has a set.
Yeah,
set of 6s or set of 7s.
I just don't think he raises with most of those hands.
I agree. I think he's also going to have a lot of combo draws, 8-9 of spades. Obviously, she doesn't block the 8 of spades, but she has an 8, which blocks, as I said, some of the straight draws. Yeah, I mean, actually, like, at a higher level, I think you're 100% right. I think that his range just really doesn't make any sense there at all. But when you have 8-3 of diamonds on king 6 7 2 spades, it's not really much else you can
right.
do.
Right, and you can't even really, like, bluff shove, because even if he's like goofing around with bottom pair, he probably has to call you.
If he calls,
so
I mean, yeah, there's just nothing. The only thing she could do is call and just hope he checks back turn. Bet river.
It's interesting that, you know, I first said, oh, she's going to win this pot. And then he goes and shows us, no,
she's supposed to win that
pot.
But
your rationale was correct.
Oh, sure.
Aggression pays. And who is the most aggressive player in that hand? The person who won it.
That's true.
Very good point.
Raise to $1,300,000.
Man, why did they build the Bagrata on a fault line?
It was a bad decision.
It's just so weird. Jessica
it's funny. Folds. It's the only one on the East Coast, too.
Jill folds. Sarah's winning.
Well,
Joseph. I thought Joseph won that
one. Ryan J. America says, terrible. Nikolai folding A6 off to Joe's open on the button with A3 off and 15 big blinds. Terrible.
I still am most shocked by Nikolai's folds with the Ace Jack.
Yeah,
that was definitely very surprising.
Small blind Joe, big blind Sarahs.
Slayer Luke, all we can say is keep it PG. Maybe we'll read your tweets on the air one day.
He's used to me ignoring his tweets and Twitch comments and direct messages and carrier pigeons and ravens.
And knocks on your window in the middle of the night.
I told him I would say on stream, he's interesting. He's an interesting guy.
I like to say, I think there's a human being in there somewhere.
He's a good guy, I think, deep down.
Yeah, exactly.
He's a little brash, and, you know, he has his moments, but he's a good guy. I've always liked Luke. Haven't always agreed with everything he's said in his
no
life.
No comment, Slay Dog. No comment. Apparently, the chat really doesn't like the A6 off fold that Nikolai made a couple hands ago, which, honestly, I didn't even notice.
Didn't register.
I don't think
it,
I mean,
register, yeah.
He could have, like, not folded, but I don't think it was, like, a massive mistake.
Yeah. Also, like I said, Joe had 15 big blinds. He opened Nikolai to 4 big blinds, and you're sitting there. In your mind, you know he's calling off. Like,
you're forgetting that the audience saw that it was ace-3 that he folded to, so of course it was a bad
fold. Everyone's a professional and they can see all the cards, huh? So this pot's been checked to the river. And I don't think we're going to see Nikolai bluff. Yeah, he might have the best hands here.
Linda Kenny Baden wants us to say, and she needs us to know, that it's fake fur. She doesn't want to get killed by PETA.
Okay. I hope that's true.
I don't really have any way of verifying that right now, so.
Well, she went out of her way to.
She went out of her way to make sure people weren't going to throw red paint on her.
That's true. And those of us who haven't been played the movies by Helen Mirren would love to have PETA come up and throw red paint on us, but she's already got the profile. She doesn't need the pub.
Luke gets back in touch to say he cares for all of us.
I care for you too, Luke. Thank you.
Sarah small blind, Nikolai big blind.
More like Jessica Daughterly. Come on, get on with it already.
Well played. Well played. That was good.
Jessica raises.
1.25.
I'm kidding. She took an incredibly reasonable amount of time.
I think the worst, you know, people talk about tanking in poker and taking too long and this and that. The worst thing for me is when people take a really, really long time before they do something like open the cutoff when they have a lot of chips.
There are some players out there who I won't even go into.
Under the gun tank is the worst, especially when you know, like, every time they're under the gun, there's going to be a tank. Like, there's nothing to calculate at that point. Like, you already could know what everyone's chip stack is. You already know what's in the middle. It's not like there's a ton of action in front of you. And your range really should be, like, pretty predetermined, like, what you're going to be doing under the gun.
I mean, sometimes you have some close spots, especially with some shorter stacks. But overall, you're definitely right. There's not many outliers in there.
For me, nothing drives me crazier than the person who tanks after the person who tanks.
Oh, my God,
that's the single worst.
It took six minutes to
get
to you.
What were you doing that whole time? By the way, this is
disaster. I was checking my app replies. Nikolai is going to get flamed now for not folding A6.
Yeah.
Well, he's certainly not going to fold the flop.
Yeah, so she down bets again, which she didn't do with the queens, and she's now done twice in a row.
I think she may be doing it just based on the board texture. That was a really
wet
board.
But I just think, like, given, I mean, small blind versus big blind with the queens, like, yes, it's not a great flop more than anything because of her, because of what, she's only playing against one person, but her, sorry, I'm a little distracted here. But, like, she doesn't need to protect on 7, 9, 10, 3 spades with two queens, with the queen of spades
against one
person. It's just like.
This card is really interesting because it's going to probably slow down both players.
That's an action killer.
Yeah, it's really going to save Nikolai a lot here. Whoa, wait. He's going to bet out.
Nikolai bets. 850,000.
Okay, never mind. It's not slowing anyone down.
Wow,
I just turned away
for 3 seconds, and I'm so confused.
Okay, so she bet the flop.
I saw all that. Yeah.
He led for very small.
Her flop
850.
Bet, it looks like. Yeah,
very small bet, and she instantly moved all in.
What?
I would generally not be doing this. I would think you're.
If I were her, I would go call.
I mean, I would definitely call the turn. I would be, like, kind of scared because I would think he's just going to have a jack sometimes.
Yeah, for sure.
For the situation that Nikolai's put himself in, I don't think he's going to get away from this.
Big shout out to Borgata for this little thing we got up here.
A little recap of the action.
Turn. Yeah, this recap of the action is pretty genius.
Yeah, that is cool.
Love it.
Someone else in the chat asks, is that the guy, the voice of Archer?
God, apparently I have a career waiting for me. Come to find out.
Tehan Pack asked that.
Great point. Oh my, oh my, oh my. What is the point of the all-in here?
I would respond with oh my, oh my, oh my.
Yeah, oh my, oh my, oh my.
I don't know. That's what although, I think when I look
you know,
at this.
Getting paid by A6. Maybe
yeah, that
answer.
Will be good. I don't know if
I
he's
going
to fold.
Yeah.
See, but like he's getting such a good price that like he may just
I think if she tank calls, if she tank shoves, he calls. But I mean, she snap shoved, you said, right?
Right, and also, like, I mean, she has to be – he's not beating any value at all.
Nothing.
So she has to be capable of just making a bluff for her tournament life in this spot
well,
in order to be able to call.
Playing for $250,000.
And I just
right
don't
now.
Know, like, not to take anything away from
think
her.
Think back
like,
to that 8-6 hands where she shoved on the ace-queen-10-8 board.
Which was – wild.
Bizarre, too.
Bizarre.
Yeah. You know, if
but she doesn't know. He doesn't know that.
He
no.
If someone, he has
no,
to watch the stream, he might.
I don't think he does.
I mean, I don't know if he does either.
Was
but
that even a half hour ago?
I would think so. Yeah.
It's close. Very close.
Yeah, the delay is 30 minutes, someone asked me in the chat. So what you're seeing is
and I feel like the person
30 minutes
that
in the past.
She jammed on before played
it. Was
it.
It was the same. It was a book as Nikolai
okay.
also.
But he didn't play it oh. as strongly.
He does make the call.
Calls the remaining 3 million.
Just too tough to lay that down.
I mean, this is
he's,
there's
yeah,
nothing better than having the zero. Yeah.
Yeah, he's just drawn to a chop, a jack, or the last ace will chop it.
Or, yeah, I was about to say a king because I'm a stupid person.
King will give Jessica two pair.
That's true. I've been playing a lot of Omaha recently.
Pretty good situation for her. Oh, wow.
Oh,
and the ace on the river beats the will chop.
The ace from space, Nikolai, has dodged a couple of huge misses at this final table, hitting the queen on the river.
I hope she has worked on her tilt control. She is not happy.
That's really frustrating, not only because you know she obviously got bad beat, but because with that pot, like I said, she's going to just cruise.
She can open up, yeah.
Yeah, and now she's still stuck in that mode.
And also he goes from chip leader to even with Frederico, and probably even with her, or right about there, if he loses that hand. Sucks.
And the Twitch chat goes wild.
God wants me to win this thing today.
Twitch chat is always a mature place.
Reese Leitner called for the six on the river on YouTube. Hopefully Nikolai
just
would have
fun.
Known. The six was no good for him.
Come on, if a six came, there at least one player at this table would have gone, oh.
I think.
I mean,
the,
I might have to be
the
honest.
Chat needs, the chat needs to really, really remember that how important it is that we can see the cards. Like, I'm reading some of this stuff, and it's like, you know, when you can watch the stuff and know everyone's cards, it's so easy to say what everyone should do, but they can't see each other's cards. It's hard for him to say, like, she always has it there or something like that because he doesn't actually know her. He's never actually played with her before now, and who knows? She could just be kamikaze bluffing.
I think I'm folding there most of the time just because I don't think anyone.
Same.
I think there's so few people. Like, I don't even care who it is. Well, actually, right. It's not true. If I'm playing against, like, someone I know to be, like, a stone-cold maniac,
yeah, sure.
then maybe. But
it happens.
Against anyone at this table, I'm probably folding.
I mean, I would just generally not try to lead there, put
yes.
myself in that situation.
For sure.
That I mean, would help a lot of things.
You turn the situation from a place where you can, like, bluff catch amazingly well. Like, when he check calls flop, I mean, on future streets, like, you – every time she's bluffing, you can catch it, and that's great. And when you lead the turn into a spot where you can't beat anything when she puts another chip in. So it turns it from, like, a great situation for you to a terrible situation. Not good.
Tarion Crawford on YouTube says, that sucks, Jessica. Paul Santoro says, how does he call that? How do these players get this far? Luke Thomas says, can we get some gags pics posted on Twitter, please?
I guess you're not going to learn. I have you beat every time.
I know, that's what
Grace.
I think you heard. I think you heard Nikolai's response to, you know, how do these players get that far? He said God wants me to win this tournament. I think he's been running well.
Did he
the
say
last
that?
Yeah, right after that. I think he's been running pretty well for the last 3 days based on that comment.
I think it's an ironic.
Oh.
God wants me.
And
to win
this will
tournament.
Certainly look tilty, and it's not.
But
that.
This is the worst, where it looks tilty, you get called by, like, a hand that's not great, and then
like,
you lose anyway.
Well, Joseph calling her would be an absolute nightmare for her. A complete, just like relative to how good her hand is and how
right.
bad his is. And
it's the worst hand that's doing pretty good against her.
This would be super telling for me if I was at the table if he folds here, because he's playing 13, 14 blinds, and he's opening, calling a raise, and then folding. I mean, it just shows some weakness in his calling range. And look, it's like she won that all in and then didn't get dealt 10s.
Yeah, basically.
A little less, but who's counting?
Oh, my, is the ace king hand would have made sense if she could actually see his hand. Yeah, maybe. But he also just might have a jack sometimes.
I also disagree because I think that person is going to, like,
fold sometimes.
Fold all, yeah. Like, you're going to get A6 to fold there a lot. If you know his hand, you call because he has 0% chance to win. Like,
yeah.
You can see his hand. Why would you ever raise him? He can't beat you.
And he's not, it's not like he's going to necessarily be gone on the river anyway.
Right. Like, yeah, I guess you get the king. And even if you get a king, queen, river, like, he's going to call rivers all the time because he thinks he has a chop against an ace.
Someone muted my microphone for a minute.
Sorry, you were saying so much. What had happened?
Well, no, it's just while that pair of legs was on screen, it was just, I was saying words, but nothing was coming out.
I missed it. I'm a loser.
It's okay. Things will turn out for you. One
I feel like that sounded like a really depressed statement when
it
I said
did.
That.
It sounded so sad, like you believed it.
I mean. Jessica waking up with some pretty playable hands here after, yes. You know, putting money into the pot with a lot of weaker hands for quite a while.
Jessica raises.
And yes, if I was Frederico, I'd be doing just this. I'd flat her every single time, make her play out of position, make her play post-flop. Oh, baby.
Pretty good flop.
Wow.
For everyone. Two blue to go with three diamonds.
Oh, I didn't realize it was three diamonds. Oh.
Does that make it? Oh, they're all blue. Okay.
Yeah, I thought it was two blue, two blue.
Oh, man, what if she makes her straight?
She is out of the tournament if she makes a non-diamond straight. Please
I really
don't
hope
raise.
He doesn't raise here.
No, he's raising.
He raised last time, you know? He might as well keep up with this.
I mean,
trend.
And the sick part is, I don't know exactly why. Like, I don't know enough to say, but she may stack off right here. Maybe it's tilt, raises. Maybe
just
it's something
for
else.
Diamonds.
She knows she's not.
2.2 million?
Well, it's like the case of Red King, you know?
That's true.
Maybe I misread it.
Like, I think she's just going to shove.
I think she might.
I really hope she
I don't know. You just have no equity if you get called here.
Yeah, 0%.
Think, yeah. She's 0% to win this. This just shows you.
I mean, retract that. I think she'll call, like, game theory-wise. Like, I think she's good enough to know to call here. But she just lost that huge hand. She knows she can pick up a huge pot. She may know. I don't know if it's been a half hour. Does she know that the guy bluff raised her? Probably not.
I don't think so.
It wouldn't be the craziest thing. I would love for her to have a diamond.
Also, you're assuming that, you know, people are instantly relaying hands to her.
Wow.
Yeah, she's going to fold.
If you have king jack with one diamond, either way, are you just...
She's got to be all in there.
Go.
I think so, yeah.
Go.
You just can't see enough good turns to flat, you think?
Yeah, with her stack size, too. I think that, like, this is a spot where, like, if she's talking to people on the rail and they're like, yo, he bluff-raised you here, she's going to be really tilted when she finds out the first one before knowing the second one.
Yeah, super happy when she finds out.
It's going to be a very long 30 minutes in between getting that information and then seeing this hand, having this hand relayed back to her.
It's so crazy because she had the 0% next to her name. I still don't know if that's a good fold. Like, I don't know about that. Like, you just bet fold the open-ended and
absolutely
over?
Absolutely nothing last time. So you could have just had, you know, stone called nothing.
Just irrelevant to any of the history, just like bet folding that hand on that board just seems like a little sacrilegious. Cause
I mean,
you
should be jamming, though, like if you think you're ever going to get a fold, and I don't know that she is, right? I mean, she's
sure.
Probably.
Well, it's hard to say because we just saw him raise with complete air. So it's close.
Right.
Have they? I guess the blinds have went up?
Blinds have just went up,
blinds
yeah.
Have just
so it's 3-6.
So this is where the poop hits the fan.
I think so.
Now's when the real poker starts.
Another big hand for Jessica. This is quite the little run she's got
having
here.
All
it's
the playables.
It's not working out for her, though, unfortunately.
No, really, basically no fault of her own.
No.
Pretty much.
Johnny. I don't know. She could have done more to prevent that chop.
Just fold, John. Come on, man. Joe. John, Joe. Tomato, tomato. Joe has more chips than I thought he did. About 5 million.
Does he? Yeah, he's got about 9.
I thought he had like 5.
Yeah, he's got about 9 or 10.
You guys are obsessed with this Joe guy. Meanwhile, I'm watching that girl on the rail stroke her own knee.
Dude, who are we? What?
See, you missed it. There's a girl with ripped jeans. The other side.
I guess I know who that is then.
Right there.
Level number 38. Wait, what? Right off camera?
Yeah.
All right. I don't know why this question is addressed to me, but Check Raise Him asks me, who would win in a fight, Asher or Slay Dog?
I'm going to give it to the Slay.
I would give
because,
it to the Slay Dog also,
but strictly,
too.
I mean, I'm not saying that there aren't other reasons he would win the fight. Strictly on, like, who, like,
they would,
I don't think Slay is crazy in terms of like crazy, but like when it comes to like something like a fight, I feel like he'd be like crazy. Like
isn't
he would fight
he
until
quite a bit taller than you too.
He's a little bit bigger. Yeah. I just think he would fight until like my soul came out of my body, literally. Like he would personally pull the soul out. So yeah, I would take the Slay, but I ain't scared of him. That being said, you know.
You guys missed that quick graphic that came up there. There's the Borgata Big Four. Every Tuesday and Thursday in the poker room, you get paid $125 for a four of a kind that you make.
Joe is all in.
Mr. Joe is all in for nine big blinds.
Quing.
I would think he is.
I don't think he's going
call.
Anywhere with this. He's
serious. Serious is going to look this sucker up.
You know, so we had an interesting situation. I, quick humble brag, I guess I got to do it. I was at the Event One final table about 6 months ago, and there was a guy who folded this in this exact spot. Guy shoved nine blind, small versus big. He folds a seven off. Do you then shove any two cards against him next time it comes small versus big and you have nine big blinds?
No, because...
See? Well, I've spent hours arguing about this after it happened with friends.
The only reason I would say no is because I feel like when people make one big fold in that
spot,
gonna
make another one.
They get very like frustrated and they like make these... I've seen the most D calls where
for
you're
sure.
like,
it's like King Deuce the next time they call.
You folded A7 and you just called with King Deuce, yeah, that type of thing. So, I mean, I don't get me wrong, I would shove extremely wide, but if I look down at exactly 3-2 off and some of those hands, I would just fold.
So the kid, and it comes back around to him next time, and he has 8-3 offsuit.
I would go all in with that.
Yeah. And he went all in, and it was like, you know, I have friends, we talk a lot of poker, and it was, I mean, we argued about it forever about what was right and what was wrong, and I really hope Sirius isn't folding here. Oh.
Probably do some math on the
that is hand. That is kooky town. Right
that hurt
there.
My soul.
That A7 fold. That is crazy pants.
That being said, I get where he's coming from, but it's you shouldn't fold that.
You know, I mean, it wouldn't have crippled him that much if he called. He still would have had 7 or 8 blinds left. So even if he's thinking about
that is
me.
Like Slay Dog on bath salts. Crazy. Right there.
Hey, Slay Dog isn't crazy. He's a lot of things. I don't think crazy.
That's why I added in the bath salts.
Yeah.
Real Mad Bomber.
Oh, bath salts. Yeah, he's crazy on bath salts for sure.
Real Mad Bomber says, see, now I thought Ash would be very scrappy.
My cards are out.
I'm scrappy. I'm just,
not
trying to
scrappy.
Pull people's souls out of their body and stuff like that. Yeah.
You know what you do is you set the fight up, and then at the last minute, you switch you out for JC Alvarado, who you look like slightly, and he's been training
okay.
as like a fighter for like the last year and a half.
I'm in for that.
He's really lean these days. I don't know if you guys have seen him lately.
No. What's going on here?
We need a...
Ash is making away with our soundboard wrapped around his body.
I am just wrapping myself everywhere.
He is losing the battle against Slay Dog and the Sonoflex.
But I know Slay Dog's listening. He should know, you know. I ain't afraid of him. Screw you, Slay Dog. Nice, great.
Nikolai picks up this pot.
Nikolai Orlov guaranteed paid out $325,000, said Southside Squash. So I guess he's pretty confident in his buddy.
Rosa Gonzalez tweets in, go Jessica Dolly. Jessica, go. Great job commentating, guys. Thank you.
And Luke Thomas writes, who is Slab Dog? Slab Dog doesn't exist. Slay Dog is Slayer, is Luke Vrabel, who's a well-known poker player. / Twitter.
No, there's
or
a slab dog
monster.
In the YouTube.
Oh, we got a slab dog.
Who says equal powers to both sex. That felling when you two diamonds on your hand and three on the river.
Slab dog is talking a little confusing.
Slab dog may be a guest in this country.
John Andre going
it's
strong.
Chris from Denmark.
Going strong on Twitter still.
We respect you and love you, John Andre.
Federico hasn't been on a date since his last final table appearance in 2012. Perhaps true. Federico facts from John Andre.
Cirrus raising the queen.
And this lull in action is really, really interesting. I mean, we were moving so quickly, and now we're just moving so slowly relative to player bust outs. It's still a lot of interesting action happening, most definitely, but it's slowed down. We've been at five people for a while.
This is where I said earlier, you know, if we don't have a big stack that's really putting pressure on, you're going to have this type of slow play until players...
Until they're flipping every hand.
Yeah, basically until two big hands clash, and that's exactly what we're seeing here, just waiting for that to happen.
Be interested to see how many total big blinds we have in play once.
Well, I'm gonna do it.
Once we flash that up there. Again.
We should have.
I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go 120.
120, yeah.
That's my wild guess.
Here's your boy JoJo.
Good luck, Joe. Good luck, buddy. Yes, and as he has been all day, he is
He's going to raise yeah.
really big.
Yeah, four big ones here.
Something like that, three or four.
2.5 mil.
It looks like two.
He's got less in his hand.
It's so interesting. Yeah, anyone else would be shoving here just because. So
he's
close.
Just
going
to shove. There you go. No more decisions. Joe moves all
in. He's a big fan of the Nike small blind.
Serious fall.
Race. You're killing today. Killing.
It's my job, everybody.
Seriously, you don't get fined.
No
huh?
other marketable skills. Luckily, I can't get fined on the internet. As well, and
Joe
will survive another the Nike small blind gets
Joe
through.
Lives another day.
Do you think he wore that on purpose? Ah, small blind.
I love the small blind.
Gotta wear this one today.
Say hello to my little blind. I don't know. I don't know him well enough, but I hope to. I hope to know him after this. I think the world's going to know him.
Shining Soju asks, how did these oddballs stumble out of their basement and through to the final table?
Ask the guy who hasn't managed to stumble out of his basement because he's home watching on Twitch. Well, some of them ask their mom's permission to leave the house. And they get a ride to the park and fly. That's right, Johnny Nags. Danger zone. Pretty much everyone here is in the danger zone.
Black Smoke Angel says they're playing a bit scared. I don't know if they're playing scared. They're just playing tight.
Cautious is different than scared.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think, you know, we see Federico just kind of raising with just Jack 4 high, and we've seen a lot of aggressive blind versus blind play with very, very marginal holdings. So I don't think scared. I mean, here he comes again, 10-2 here. Just, you know, these guys are not scared.
Scared's different
than not
reckless.
Clearly Joe isn't scared because he just went all in.
No, Federico went all in.
Oh, did he?
Wait. I'm not sure. The all-in button's in front of Joe, but our graphics are look a little wrong here. I think Federico raised, and then Joe moved all-in is what happened to
that
you.
Is
I
guess, too.
And he's counted out right now.
Yeah.
So
Federico is wasting lives.
This I don't care for either, is when you ask for a count with a hand that you're clearly not going to call it.
And Federico lays it down.
Oh.
Yeah, Joe had a big hand there.
Joe is
I don't. I don't. Okay. I've sometimes asked for counts when I know I'm folding, just because I want to know. Like, let's say I raise and I don't expect my opponent to shove, where like they have a lot of chips and they have like 25 big blinds or 26 big blinds or something like that, where I don't expect the play to always be all in, and I'll raise and then they'll shove, and I'll say like, yeah, I want to like, did I count wrong or how many chips are that? Like, what are you doing this with? Just to give me a better idea of.
But it's not a Hollywooding thing.
No. I'm certainly. You know, trying to think about more things than that.
I've recently just, for a while now, snap folded in all situations, always, ever. I don't even if I do the most ridiculous thing, I'll just snap fold when they.
Especially once you get down the, you know, four or five handed, like everyone knows what's going on. You know that like people are raising light.
I guess
it's
no one
like,
has aces every hand.
Exactly.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't want to get caught bluffing.
Right.
It'll ruin me. Ruin me.
Pretty upset that Jessica hasn't ate any baby food since this final table
started. She said she's off
that
diet. I asked her.
Is she off the diet? She was on a huge cleanse / I don't even know.
Here you go. Show the ace. He's not bluffing, guys.
There you go.
God wants me to win this tournament, and he also said I should show you this ace.
You're kidding me. That's a good question. If you were one of these players, what would your approach be to your new bankroll? After winning all this money, what do you think?
I would retire from poker forever. You would never see me again. Like, now, granted, I may just end up like dying in the Spearmint Rhino, like that.
Yeah, night. I was thinking that you probably are. That's
or I would just buy a condo and then just own a home, and you would never see me play poker.
And then
again.
Have no money to furnish the home.
I would work for a living after that.
Okay.
Well, I think the number one thing to answer that question is self-awareness. Like, how aware are these people of how good they are at poker and of their other life opportunities, et cetera, et cetera.
Also depends if they're professionals or not.
Sure.
Yeah.
Jump immediately into a 100, 200 Omaha game.
I think that's a great idea.
On the way out the door.
Yeah.
I actually think that's genius, personally.
There's been, I've seen numerous times people winning very large tournaments online very late in the early in the morning and instantly jumping into $5,000 sit and goes or high stakes cash and losing all of it. Those graphs are always fun to look at.
Yeah, for sure.
Look, he won 250,000. Oh, he lost it all.
There are a lot of very dumb humans out there.
Yeah.
One thing that we haven't been seeing is big blinds have been folding at a ridiculous clip.
Yeah,
to raises.
Sure.
I mean, a lot of the raises have been huge, but they've just been, you haven't been seeing any peeling, which, like, I'm sure, like, the EPTs you do, everyone's calling peeling out a big blind every time, right?
Oh, no one folds your big blind ever.
Yeah, ever.
It's crazy.
Yeah, never.
Again, it just shows you the styles, the difference in styles between European and American.
I was talking to Vanessa Selfs about this, too, in that people, it's almost like the flop doesn't count anymore either.
Yeah.
Like, it's just always bet call on the flop, like 100% of the time. Like, people don't even really even start thinking about folding until the turn.
Right, right.
Guys, play online, BorgataPoker.com. You can win entry into the Wednesday 10,000 guaranteed tournament. It's guaranteed every Wednesday. Actually, every day, there's a $10,000 guaranteed tournament on Borgata Poker. Oh, this is a live one.
Yes.
Okay, so play online, and you can win entry to the 10,000 live one. Online also, there is a 10,000 guarantee.
Every day.
Tournament every day. And then, you know, obviously you have your live rooms here. Hey, you know what you do? You take that iPad, you come here, you play the 10,000 guarantee live while you play the 10,000 guarantee online.
That's
we got
that's
everything covered here.
All of it. We got a mobile app. It's a beautiful thing.
I'll tell you, that's like my favorite thing about having – you know, poker here is that, you know, we could play some of these Sunday tournaments and then play live at the same time. That's, that's so cool.
Really you guys have tablets and stuff?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can play, mobile.
Let's be realistic over here.
Just make sure you're playing at BorgataPoker.com, you know.
Check Razum says, American poker knit donk, Euro aggro genius.
Grinding daily would give someone 500 to hit Stapes in the face once.
If you could prove that, you're
cancerous.
If you can show the 500 bucks, like if you could prove that I'll get it, I'll give you 200 Stapes.
It's a negative free roll for you.
Why, you got a little sleigh dog in you?
No, I'm just saying, like, you know, these people on the internet with their
it's certainly a negative free roll. But we could split the money and not too bad. So, yes, I mean, that person was a little bit right, though. The play definitely has slowed down a little. People are folding some hands that they wouldn't have folded before. Sirius has really kind of slowed down as well.
You think fatigue is setting in?
A little bit, yeah. Also, I think it was funny. We were talking about how relaxed they are once they're guaranteed 90,000. But they're also, it's like that 300,000 at the top, like when you're in day two, it doesn't actually exist.
Great example, by the way. Just
King seven. I mean,
very quickly folding.
I would just never fold.
A lot of players would certainly not. But
sure.
This is part of the reason. I mean, the structure's pretty shallow. I mean, it's not that shallow, but people are definitely more afraid to like make looser defends and stuff when they don't have a lot of chips. So I think that's also part of it.
Yeah,
here.
For sure. Most definitely. Yeah, I just think now that they're this close, they can see $325,000 right in front of their face. So it's like, wait, I should, like, play tight and play seriously and try to win all that money, you know? I think that's a lot of what happens. Speaking to Jessica earlier, she said this win would have extra, extra, extra significance to her as it falls on September 11th. She was a Air Force, right?
Correct, for 6 years.
Air Force, yeah. Actually said she was locked in a vault doing training exercises when it happened and thought it was a training exercise.
Wow.
Said it was one of the craziest days of her life and this would be just great. Given the situation.
Frederico folds his small blind. 1 point.
She does still seem like, obviously not right there in that moment. She seems like she's as awake as she ever has been. You know, there's no lull for her. She's talking to her rail and
she definitely has the biggest rail out of all these guys.
That's
here.
It's important too, though, just to keep yourself interested and keep your energy level up.
I never really knew what like the big rail could do, and it's something else. Like having a big rail is crazy. It really helps.
At the WP.